here. We're going to go through all of our movement progressions. The first one's the most fundamental, not just for wrestling, but for fitness. Noah, go ahead and start in a plank. Face, like, kind of that corner there. Go in a plank position. I don't care how wide we start with our feet, but what we're focused on is the opposite of butt in the air. We want to pull the tummy in, but tuck the butt underneath and get as low towards the floor. See the hips fully open. We want to be able to breathe here. Once the athlete can breathe here and maintain what we call like this neutral spine where we're not breaking. Then we're going to work on a mountain climber where you're bringing your knee to your elbow. Go ahead and like, demonstrate that. Good. Real good. And then what I want you to do is try a frog here where we go completely off of the ground with those back legs and then kick back. Good. Now keep going. Just breathe through it as much as you can. In through your nose, out through your mouth. You don't have to go to the mountain climber. Stick with your frog now. So we're going to have our younger kids work on the plank and the mountain climber. By middle and high schoolers, we should have most of our athletes being able to breathe or talk like I am through this progression. Staying in a plank. And then this is what we're going to start to work on now is stretching from that strength to your warrior lunge, Noah. The biggest mistake kids will make is coming onto their toes. This is what we don't want. We want to sit back on the heel, find the heel, and get the hip below the knee. And you can see the chest is high, the hip is low, what we see in a lunge or a squat. Go ahead and go back and forth, though. Let's just do three each side. Kind of give your hands and upper body a break. Open up the hips. All right, so three down, three to go. Good. And then after this one on your left, go right back into your frog. So set up in a long plank. Good. Good. Nice. Brace and breathe. Brace and breathe and kick back. Just go 1 to 2 seconds here. Kind of like wrestling when we practice all of our moves here. We don't want to hold a position. We want to get in position, get out of position, transitions, transitions. There you go. Doesn't have to be rushed as long as it's controlled. Nice. Keep going and now go to your warrior lunge. No, you're there. Go to your warrior lunges. Good. So it'll give me the last level that we want to try to get our kids to do is be able to go to that frog in the look. And the head pointing up. And this is taking your plank from horizontal to vertical orientation. So after your next warrior lunge, I want you to try that. So we go from plank, get in the strong mountain climber, learn your frog, go to your head, tuck your chin. Good. We'll start to strengthen up the neck here too. Great for all sports, but especially wrestling. Good, good, good. Now keep going through. Let's say we set the timer for 20 to 30 seconds. Go as slow and controlled as you can. You only need 2 to 3 good reps. One down, 1 or 2 more to go. Straighten out, get as long as you can. Now slow and controlled on the way down. Good, good, good. One more time. Good, and that's kind of a start of this concept of heavy hands. So when you're doing your plank, your frog, your headstand, you want to be heavy on your hands. And then in between those rounds, we're going to open up the hips with warrior lunges last time through. Real good, no one just perfect.